Right now, the trial of Chandler Halderson is set to resume tomorrow. We'll recap some of the key highlights from the first 6 days. Also, tracking COVID-19 through wastewater. New data suggests there's good news, but why scientists are asking for patience. Plus, how some parts of Wisconsin are honoring the late Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. News 3 Now at 6 starts right now. Hello, everybody. Thanks for joining us. Eric and Charlotte are off tonight. The nearly week-long gap in the Halderson trial may make it more difficult to remember some of the key highlights of the first 6 days. Before court resumes tomorrow morning, Naomi Coles is here with a recap.
Don't assume anything.
Tomorrow will mark 2 weeks since day one and opening statements. That's when we learned what still stands as one of the most significant things so far, possible motive.
He cut up their bodies with axes and saws and knives. And he didn't even give them the dignity of having a funeral or even a final resting place in one
place. Prosecutors accuse Halderson of creating a web of lies about his supposed job and school to his parents, which started falling apart in the days leading up to their murder.
So my brother was listed in the same line as I was.
And we learned from his brother's testimony that the sons would get $1 million in life insurance if both parents died. Day two, we saw a video of Chandler going to his neighbors door by door looking for security footage after his parents disappeared.
I was wondering if you were able to capture the road or my house.
The police actually came and downloaded everything they have.
Yeah, did it capture anything on?
We don't know.
On trial day three, the jurors saw pictures of his parents' dismembered bodies, pictures we aren't showing you, and we heard from Chandler's girlfriend.
Kat, did you have absolutely anything to do with cleaning anything up or their disappearance?
Day four, we saw the first full interview police had with him.
This is the only chance you're going to have to tell us the truth.
And then last Monday, day five, we got our first look at what detectives found in the Halderson home, a bloody axe, body remains. Day six, we learned Chandler's shoes were stained with his parents' blood. That's where the trial left off last Tuesday, when Halderson tested positive for COVID-19. Now, through all of this, the defense has been very limited. They had about 10 minutes of opening statements, plus their cross-examination of witnesses hasn't been much. So as the prosecution prepares to wind down their case, that's what we'll be listening for, the defense side. For News 3 Now, I'm Naomi Coles.
Naomi, thank you. If you want to get caught up with the trial, we have a page dedicated to it on channel3000.com. There you'll be able to live stream the trial as it's happening and catch up on all the latest updates. We also have a full timeline of events from the case leading up to the trial, including a News 3 Now interview with Chandler Halderson just before his arrest. Again, you can find all of this on channel3000.com. Now let's check your certified most accurate forecast with Chief Meteorologist Gary Kenalty. Gary?
Today wasn't a bad day by January standards. Temperatures were about average, and tomorrow they'll actually be a little milder. The time lapse for the Queen Bee Radio Sky Cam in Platteville shows some morning clouds giving way to clear skies later on this afternoon with some sunshine coming on through. But the clouds will start coming back in from the west later on tonight. You can already see some light snow showers and flurries up toward the Twin Cities. We could see a couple of flurries or even a little drizzle by this time tomorrow with temperatures in the middle 30s. Right now, our low temperatures this morning started out in the upper teens to the lower 20s. High temperatures so far right around 30. Madison topped out at 29. Janesville topped out at 30. And temperatures have dropped back into the middle 20s, but as those clouds move in, those temperatures will be slower to fall later on tonight. And you can see wind chills really aren't much of a factor because the winds are light. But those winds will be a factor on Thursday and Thursday night with the possibility for wind chills down to 20 to 25 below zero at times and high temperatures only in the single digits on Thursday. So we have an alert day in the forecast for Thursday and Thursday night. Look for variably cloudy skies tonight. Low temperature of 18 around midnight with steady temperatures overnight. Tomorrow's high 36. And again, a couple of flurries or a little drizzle in the afternoon. More on that big blast of cold air are headed our way in just a few minutes.
All right, Gary, thank you. Today we remember civil rights icon Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Dr. King was a Baptist minister and activist who became the most visible spokesman and leader of the civil rights movement. He advanced civil rights through the power of speech and acts of nonviolent resistance. Dr. King won the Nobel Peace Prize in 1964 and was assassinated 4 years later. This year commemorates what would have been his 93rd birthday. Right now, the city of Madison is observing the holiday with a special virtual event. Ilia Sasha Baz, the daughter of civil rights leader Malcolm X, is serving as the keynote speaker. You can find a link to watch it on the city's MLK King Coalition website. And we'll have more from this event coming up tonight on News 3 Now at 10. The road in Milwaukee, named after Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., is getting a little longer today. City officials marked the holiday by renaming North Old World 3rd Street from Wisconsin Avenue to McKinley Avenue after King. Last year, the city council unanimously voted in favor of extending King's name to the additional half-mile stretch of the road. In other news tonight, getting your COVID test results is testing people's patience in Dane County. Many test sites are extending their anticipated turnaround times due to the sheer number of people looking to see if they have COVID. Fitchburg Family Pharmacy says it's averaging an 80-hour wait time for test results. That's 3.5 days. Forward Pharmacy in McFarland says it's taking at least 3 days as well. Pharmacist Tony Pietrangelo with Forward Pharmacy believes this is due to the overall surge in cases countywide.
There have been times when testing was lighter, when we were getting our test results back in less than a day, which was awesome. But right now, the most recent test results have been coming back in 3 or more days.
Public Health reopened its COVID test site at the Alliant Energy Center last week. PHMDC uses a company called Accelerated Labs to do its tests, aiming for a 48 to 72 hour turnaround time. Moderna is working on a single shot that covers both the flu and COVID. The pharmaceutical company's CEO says it should help address concerns that some people have about getting separate COVID and flu shots. Moderna is not planning to have the vaccine ready until the fall of 2023, and even then, it will only be available in some countries. Throughout the course of the pandemic, scientists have relied on a number of ways to track the spread of COVID. But one method has given researchers a look at COVID on a community-wide level: wastewater monitoring. Right now, data from the Wisconsin Department of Health Services seems to show a considerable decline in the virus's presence in Madison's sewage system. But because wastewater samples include a mix of everything that gets flushed down a drain, it can be difficult to find the virus. That's why scientists working at the COVID-19 wastewater surveillance program say we should be patient.
As a state, I would say we're not past the peak yet. Just that's how it's looking. Whether Madison is maybe turning the corner faster, I would want to hope with everybody else, but we don't know that yet. We'll need another week or two maybe of data to really see where it's going.
Late last week, health officials in Rock County said wastewater monitoring led them to believe COVID-19 is much more prevalent in the community now than it has ever been. A Platteville woman is dead after crashing her vehicle yesterday. Grant County Sheriff's officials say 22-year-old Olivia Zimmer was traveling south on 151 north of Airport Road just before 2 a.m. when she lost control of her vehicle. Zimmer was ejected from the vehicle. She was taken to a local hospital where she later died of her injuries. The incident remains under investigation. Monroe police say they arrested two teens after they allegedly beat another teen last night. According to police, a group of four boys was seen beating another on the 2200 block of 10th Street just before 11. Police found and arrested a 16-year-old from Monroe and a 15-year-old from Broadhead. Multiple other suspects have been identified in the case. It remains under investigation. The Milwaukee County Medical Examiner's Office says they have identified the young girl shot and killed over the weekend. Police say they're investigating the death of 8-year-old Tiana Huddleston as a homicide. A 47-year-old man is accused of handling a firearm that went off and struck Huddleston. The man was taken into custody. Neighbors in the area feel the city isn't doing enough to stop the violence, and that has a strong community initiative that could help prevent future incidents.
neighborhood watch group. Whatever happened to that type of thing? And especially since this coronavirus and we're wearing masks, we definitely don't speak to our neighbors. So, you know, we're not getting any closer to being a community. Matter of fact, we're growing far, far away from being a community.
Police say criminal charges will be referred to the Milwaukee County District Attorney's Office in the coming days. Still to come tonight at 6, homes are still getting more expensive in Wisconsin. The latest numbers from the Wisconsin Realtors Association. Plus, how you can help the Madison School District keep in-person classes going as the district continues to deal with staffing shortages.
Watching Madison's fastest growing newscast, News 3 Now at 6.
What you see is important. How you see is important too. Get personalized care from experienced optometrists at Shopko Optical. Better eye care. You'll see.
Right now, get 40% off frames with any lens purchase.
At Blaine's Farm and Fleet, we're your hardware headquarters. Your one-stop shop for quality name brand tools, welding supplies, and accessories, all at great low prices. Right now, save $60 on this DeWalt compact drill driver kit, just $99. Get a free DeWalt 20-volt battery when you buy a qualifying Behr tool. All welding wire and rods are 15% off. And keep tools handy with this Bucket Boss suspension rig, just $49.99.
Find value at Blaine's Farm and Fleet. Winter in Wisconsin means snow, blustering winds, and sub-zero temperatures. Will your insulation keep your home warm? Fry Construction can always help. We're your roofing and insulation pros. We'll find cracks and air pathways in your insulation that are letting in the icy cold and hindering your comfort. With our thermal imaging and our cutting-edge insulation techniques, you'll be sure that your home will be warm and energy efficient for many years to come. Visit fryconstruction.com today and prepare your home for the long winter.
The Washington Swamp. Ron Johnson's up to his neck in it. It's no surprise Johnson broke his promise to only serve 2 Senate terms as his net worth doubled in office. Johnson pushed for a new tax loophole for the wealthiest Americans, personally benefited from the tax break, and 2 of his biggest donors pocketed millions. Ron Johnson's deep in the swamp, out for himself, not us. SMP is responsible for the content of this ad.
What you see is important. That makes quality eye care important too. Get personalized care from experienced optometrists at Shopko Optical. Better eye care. You'll see. Schedule your comprehensive eye exam at shopko.com or bring in your outside prescription.
The Madison School District is calling for parents and community volunteers to help them fill a number of important positions in schools. The district is looking for volunteers to help serve in a number of roles, from classroom support to clerical support and supervising students during arrival, dismissal, lunch, and recess. A district spokesperson says those volunteers are critical to helping keep schools open for students amid the pandemic, and also takes extra responsibilities off of teachers.
We have been hovering at this threshold of critical staffing levels. And so anything that we can do to free up some of our teaching staff is certainly going to help.
If you'd like to learn more about what positions are available, we've posted a link on our website, channel3000.com. The Wisconsin Realtors Association says the median price that rose for a house rose more than 7% over a 12-month period between November of 2020 and November of last year. According to the data, the median home price is now $240,000. The Wisconsin Realtors Association also found housing affordability slipped. While the median home price is up more than 7%, the median family income rose an estimated 1% during that same time. A large number of firefighters are docking in, freighters are docking in Sturgeon Bay for some much needed maintenance. Coming up, how workers at Sturgeon Bay are making sure the Great Lakes fleet is ready to sail for this year's shipping season. Plus, just how cold is it going to get this week? Gary has a look at your complete forecast coming up after the break.
keep your vehicle running smoothly with automotive products at Menards. AC Delco batteries set the standard for performance, reliability, and offer an industry-leading warranty. Don't be left stranded this winter and grab an AC Delco Advantage automotive battery starting at $94.99 on sale with exchange. Quaker State Ultimate Durability Motor Oil helps improve fuel economy while protecting against engine wear. Grab a quart for only $3.49 after sale price and $2 rebate right now at Menards.
Save big money at Menards.
Water is one of nature's most beautiful and life-sustaining resources. At no fault of their own, many Wisconsin utility customers are facing a shutoff to their water service. This leaves them without the one life-giving resource we all take for granted. And those hardest hit are on fixed incomes, juggling multiple temporary jobs, or those who lost full-time jobs in sectors hardest hit by the pandemic. If someone you care about needs a hand up, your local Wisconsin energy and emergency rental assistance providers are working together to keep you safely in your home and your water, heat, and power on. If you are in danger of losing your water service, call 833-H2O-WISC, 833-426-9472. You may not ask for it, but we're here to help.
Guys, do you suffer from erectile dysfunction? Now there's great news. Peak Performance for Men will help you regain your performance and confidence naturally. Peak Performance for Men uses an advanced form of acoustic wave therapy, clinically shown to open up and regrow blood vessels, restoring normal and natural functionability where it counts most. There are no needles, no surgery, and best of all, no pain. Call now and receive an ultrasound, your initial consultation, all for free, in over $300 value. Call Peak Performance for Men today.
McGann Furniture in downtown Baraboo should probably be called McGann Furniture and Flooring because we're the area's oldest and most experienced floor covering store. Our friendly staff will explain the many types of flooring available, answer questions, and make suggestions so you can choose what's best for your home and lifestyle. We always offer free in-home measurements and estimates and use the finest installers in the entire area. And remember, at McGann's, we don't inflate prices only to mark them down for a sale. Stop in today and discover the difference. You'll be glad you did. McGann Furniture, downtown Baraboo.
Welcome back, everyone. It's a busy time at Fincantieri Bay Shipbuilding in Sturgeon Bay. Eric Peterson has more as the winter fleet there begins to gather.
On a very cold Sunday morning in the Sturgeon Bay Shipping Channel, the 680-foot-long John J. Boland creeps its way into place. Ice fisherman Forrest Jacobs has a front row seat.
It's pretty neat. I've done it a couple times. It's pretty cool to see if you want to walk out there and look at it. You can feel the pressure change. It's pretty cool. A little scary, I guess, too, you know, if you're not used to it.
Photographer Joe Rainier follows the freighters online and with his camera, too.
I like to get out and enjoy it because, you know, a lot of people miss this, and I like to share them with others. You know, see them as well on Facebook and stuff, so other people can see it too.
The Great Lakes freighter is one of the first to join the winter fleet at Fincantieri Bay Shipbuilding in Sturgeon Bay.
They come into port for what they call the winter layup. So all of the crew kind of go home for the next month, 2 months, 3 months, and that's when our busy season really kicks in.
Destination Sturgeon Bay Marketing and Events Director Carly Sarkis says employees at the shipyard work 24/7. To make sure the fleet is ready to sail. She says maintenance, repairs, and even painting are common. The work has to be completed in about 2 to 3 months because the Great Lakes shipping season typically resumes the third week of March.
To have this type of activity here in Sturgeon Bay during January, February, and March, it helps us so much. I think it brings extra tourism. It's great for economic growth all around. So it's interesting to see, and I'm happy that it's gaining more traction.
Certainly is interesting to see. Now let's check back in with Gary for a complete look at the forecast. Gary?
Well, we got some changes on the way in our weather. Today was about seasonably cold. Tomorrow might even be a little bit above average. There could be a couple of flurries or a little bit of drizzle during the day tomorrow with temperatures in the mid-30s. Maybe a little freezing drizzle tomorrow night before it comes to an end as temperatures drop to just below freezing during the evening hours. But the big drop in temperatures will occur later tomorrow night into Wednesday. Wednesday's high temperatures will be in the mid-teens early in the day with temperatures falling into the single digits by late afternoon. And then it turns bitterly cold with low temperatures in the single digits to near 10 degrees below zero and daytime highs only in the single digits on Thursday. So an alert day in the forecast for Thursday and Thursday night. The colder of the two nights, probably Thursday night, but there'll be a little bit less wind. So the wind chills might be a little bit colder on Thursday morning compared to Thursday night. But even during the day on Thursday, high temperatures only in the single digits above zero means wind chills will stay at or below zero. Right now, just a few snow flurries up in northern Wisconsin, a couple of snow showers in Minnesota. Our skies will turn cloudy overnight, and you can see the snow depth is pretty prevalent across our part of the Midwest. There's a little break to the south and east, and of course, the big storm dumping the heavy snow just over the last couple of days in the eastern part of the country. But this area here with very little or no snow cover from eastern Colorado through the western high plains, that's an area that warmed up very nicely today. Over that bare ground, temperatures were in the 50s and 60s, whereas over the snow cover, we are seasonably cold. Some of that milder air will move eastward, but the main storm track is in between the colder air to the northeast and the milder air to the southwest. That sets up a jet stream out of the northwest here, and then that curves around. So we're seeing these storm systems heading up the east coast, whereas the Midwest seeing much weaker storm systems and just periodic shots of cold air when the winds are out of the northwest over the snow cover, whereas when our winds are out of the southwest off of that bare ground, our temperatures warm up. And notice to the west, there is a warm front here that's heading in our direction. That'll bring temperatures back into the mid-30s for tomorrow. Right now, we're in the mid-20s. Temperatures probably bottoming out in the upper teens overnight, but notice over parts of western Iowa, western Minnesota, temperatures are already in the 30s. And on future track, you can see the skies clouding up overnight, those winds out of the south, maybe a couple of flurries or a little drizzle during the afternoon tomorrow, maybe a little freezing drizzle tomorrow night. And then notice the wind shift to the northwest by Wednesday morning. And that's when the colder air starts dropping in. And as the skies clear out, temperatures will nosedive by early on Thursday morning down to below zero, with wind chills perhaps as cold as 20 to 25 degrees below zero. Tomorrow, mostly cloudy, a little milder than today with a high of 36. Again, a few flurries, maybe a little drizzle during the afternoon. And then you can see that drop in temperatures. 15 for high on Wednesday early in the day with falling temperatures. Bitterly cold for Thursday. Friday back up to 15. A brief warm up on Saturday with a few flurries. And then very cold weather for the first half of next week. High temperatures in the teens. Nighttime low temperatures above and below zero.
And coming up in sports, the Badgers climbing up in the polls where Wisconsin sits in the latest AP Top 25. That's next on News 3 Now.
News 3 Now First Warn Weather is brought to you by Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor.
Discover a shopping and design experience as comfortable as the furniture. Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor. Schedule your free design consultation today.
Celebrated as best of the year across the country, the New York Times calls it a timely show that has become a sensation and a wildfire, something every citizen must see. What the Constitution means to me. Tickets at overture.org.
Credit score getting in the way of things you want to do? Personal loans through NetCredit help you borrow up to $10,000. So check your eligibility on netcredit.com today without affecting your credit score. You may even be able to build your credit history as you repay. NetCredit, a more personal, personal loan.
Clog their defenses.
Sir, yes, sir!
Charge!
Combat leaves debris and damage to your home and property all year round with a solution you can get and forget. LeafGuard is the only gutter system guaranteed never to clog, whatever the weather. Call 1-833-LeafGuard today for a free in-home estimate and get a $50 gift card. Defend your gutters from clogs forever with LeafGuard. Call 1-833-LeafGuard today.
From open borders, increasing crime, and rising inflation, Democrat policies are weakening America.
When I ran in 2016,
I intended to serve a second term and go home. But today, our nation is on a very dangerous path. If you could help make America safer and stronger, would you walk away? I've decided I can't. I'll stand and fight for freedom. I'm Ron Johnson, and I approve this message because I love America and Wisconsin, just like you.
See the boundary-breaking play that breathes new life into our Constitution and imagines how it will shape the next generation of Americans. Direct from Broadway, don't miss the 2019 Tony-nominated Best Play, What the Constitution Means to Me. Tickets at Overture.org.
During dry winter months, humidifiers can improve your home's air quality if you keep them clean. We'll give you the experts' top tips.
And we could be seeing some light flurries for our morning commute. We'll have your forecast from 4:37 tomorrow morning.
Remember back before the college basketball season tipped off when the Badgers were picked to finish 10th in the Big Ten? Well, that team has now cracked the top 10 in the AP Top 25. Wisconsin sits at number 8 in the country. It's their highest ranking since week 7 of last season. The Badgers are currently on a 6-game win streak, and if they beat Northwestern tomorrow, they'll move into first place in the Big Ten standings. The Bucks with an early 5 o'clock tip today, taking on the Hawks. Right now at the half, Milwaukee leads by 12. We'll have highlights tonight at 10. There was no change for the Badger women's hockey team in this week's poll. Wisconsin still claims the top spot in the nation, even after having the weekend off. UW returns to the ice this weekend with a trip to Minnesota to take on the 5th-ranked Gophers on Friday and Saturday. The stage is set for the divisional round at Lambeau Field on Saturday night with a regular season rematch between the Packers and the 49ers. And that week 3 game was a wild one. Green Bay trailed by 1 with 37 seconds left, and that was just way too much time for Aaron Rodgers. He led the Packers in the field goal range, and Mason Crosby booted a 51-yard field goal to win the game. Saturday's rematch is set for 7:15 on Fox. Braylon Allen has been named a freshman All-American by the Football Writers Association of America. The Badger running back rushed for over 1,200 yards and 12 touchdowns, while averaging 6.8 yards per carry in his first season at UW. Allen is Wisconsin's first FWAA freshman All-American since 2017, when Tyler Biadasz and Jonathan Taylor were selected to the team. And Donna Kelsey might be the front runner for Mom of the Year in 2022. She's the mother of Chiefs tight end Travis Kelce and Eagles center Jason Kelce. Both of them had playoff games yesterday. The Eagles played in Tampa at noon. She was there. And then Donna flew to Kansas City and made it to Arrowhead Stadium, even though her flight was delayed a bit. Two games, nearly 1,300 miles. One supermom. And Gary, she even crashed the Chiefs post-game news conference to ask her son a question.
She probably has good frequent flyer miles from that. Well, skies are mostly clear here in Madison, but they will start clouding up before too long. Temperatures are in the lower to middle 20s. Here in Madison, we're at 23. Temperatures will fall off to the upper teens by around midnight and then hold nearly steady overnight in the upper teens through tomorrow morning. Look for a high tomorrow of about 36, maybe a few flurries or a little drizzle in the afternoon, but sharply colder on Wednesday with falling temperatures. A high of only 7, bitterly cold on Thursday with lows below 0, and very cold for the first half of next week as well.
All right, Gary, thank you. Thanks so much for watching, everybody. Enjoy your evening. Hope to see you back here for News 3 at 10.